Now, in this session, we are going to do one screen design example by using weights. Let us consider this screen design. Now, in this session, we are going to design only the body part. So, observe the body part. Our screen design body part contains one image view, which contains one image called as skillgun.com. Don't think that it is a text view. It is one image view. That image view is displaying a predefined image called as skillgun.com. I will be sharing that image also with you. Can you guess what are the elements available just below image view? Though it looks like image views, but they are not actually image views. They are 7 different text views. Now, if you observe carefully, I have distributed screen proportion to all these 8 views, one image view and one text view. Can you guess the weights or the proportions of all these views? If you observe carefully, that image view is occupying 2 proportions, whereas other text views, whereas other 7 text views are occupying 1:1:1 and so on proportions. So let me write the proportions here. You don't have to really do the rocket science to understand these proportions. By looking at this picture only, it is very much clear that image view is occupying 2 proportions of the screen and other text views are occupying 1 proportion each. That means we are going to divide the overall screen height into 9 equal proportions, because 2 plus 7 ones, which is equivalent to 9 proportions, and we are going to give 2 proportions to image views and 1 proportion for each text view. Apart from that, if you observe carefully, there is a space before the content of each text view. There is a space. Let us say this space is roughly around 20 dp, or let us say 20 pixels. And if you observe the image inside the image view, that image is aligned at the center. Can you tell me what type of linear layout it is? Is it vertical linear layout or horizontal linear layout? Obviously, it is vertical linear layout, because all the elements are aligned one below each other. Observe, one below each other, and all elements are facing towards y-axis. That means all elements are touching y-axis. We should obviously take vertical linear layout. I hope you understood. Now, since we are going to apply weights, tell me which one we have to make 0 dp, either height or width. For vertical linear layout, before applying weights, we should make height as 0 dp. The reason for making height as 0 dp is, once we make all views height as 0 dp, that means you are telling to Android that the entire height is 0 dp. The remaining space of the screen should be divided in terms of proportions. I hope you understood. Now, for all these text views, I have given different colors. If you are not sure about the color codes of these text views, as I told you already, you can use the color picker application to get the exact color code. For your convenience, I have mentioned all these color codes in the notepad. Let me open that notepad. Please make a note of these color combinations. First text view's background color is #FF7F27. Similarly, second text view's background color is, that is data sufficiency's background color is #ED1C24, and so on. So total we have 7 text views. I have mentioned 7 colors here. You can make a note of it. And if you observe, the common point for all the text views is the text color is white. What is the color code for white color? #6Fs or 3Fs. You can use anything. With this basic understanding, let me show you how to design the screen. Now, so far we have discussed only about text views, edit text and buttons. In this example, I am going to show you how to use image views also. It's very simple. It is just like any other view. In order to display an image on an image view, first you have to take that corresponding image. First you have to copy that corresponding image, that is skillgun.com, into your applications drawable folder. If you remember our initial sessions, I told that all the code will be stored in SRC folder and all screen designs will be stored in layout folder and all images will be stored in the drawable folder. If I have not covered that point, just make a note. Whatever the images required for your application, please copy all those images into drawable folder. Anyway, we have a separate session covering only images. For time being, you can remember this point. First, you have to copy this skillgun.com image into drawable folder. Then you have to open your XML and take a vertical linear layout which contains 8 views, image view and 7 text views. I will directly show you how to apply that corresponding image on the image view. Now, I have created a new application in Android Studio and I have opened activity_main.xml. First step is, whatever the image required for your application, first copy that image into resources drawable folder. Now, I have Skillgun image here on the desktop. Let me copy this and I will open resource folder. I will click on drawable folder. Simply use Ctrl V to paste that image into drawable folder. Ctrl V. Now it is asking, do you want to copy this image into drawable folder? Just click OK. That image is copied. That image name is action_image.png. Android supports different image formats, PNG, JPG, JPEG and so on. Don't worry too much about image formats. For time being, you can take any image format. Now, after copying image into drawable folder, now I will go to activity XML. In place of relative layout, let me take linear layout and I have to take orientation as vertical. Already one text view is available. Let me remove this. Now I will go to design perspective. First I will drag and drop image view. You can observe the first element is layout, second element is widget. Under widget you can observe image view here. Let me drag and drop image view. So currently it is not showing any image. So let me keep it like that. Image view is ready. Just below image view, as per our requirement, we need 7 text views. Preferably I will take large text views so that font size will appear bigger. You can observe here large text. Let me drag and drop 7 text views. With this total, I have 7 text views. Now if you observe here, our initial screen design will look like this, but our final screen design should look like this. Now let us start modification. First, let me distribute weights for all the views. Since we are in the vertical linear layout, I will go to each view. I will change height as 0 dp and for image view, I will give weight as 2 and for other text views, I will give weight as 1 each. Now I will go to text perspective, make height as 0 dp, weight 2, text view 1, make height as 0 dp, weight as 1 and I will copy paste these two properties for rest of the text views. Remember, you can use one property only once. So before pasting height property and weight property, first remove existing height property, then paste it. With this, we have made second text view height as 0 dp and weight as 1. Similarly, I will do the modification for other text views. With this, I have applied weight. As of now, don't worry about text appearance. I will cover this property in the next sessions. Now, with this modification, let me open the preview. You can observe they are equally distributed. As per our requirement, image view, currently it is not showing any image and just below image view, we have text views. Now, as per the requirement, I will make each view width as match parent. If you observe carefully, each view's width is match parent. They are occupying complete parent's width. Slowly you can observe, it is getting reflected on the preview. Now I will show you how to apply this image onto image view. It's very simple. Image view has a property called as SRC property, that is source property. Now I will use that SRC property. SRC property says that where is the image available. We know that we have copied all images into drawable folder. I will select a drawable folder. What is the name of our image? Our image name is action image. So select that action image. It will automatically appear on the image view. It is as simple as that. Use SRC property @drawable/your image name. Though our image name is action_image.png, you don't have to specify png. In fact, you are not supposed to specify .png. It will take extension automatically. Now let me change text of all text views accordingly. First text view text is puzzles. Second text view text is data sufficiency, aptitude, IQ test, arithmetic, reasoning, and analytical. So with this I have changed the content. Now let me apply background color as well as text color. I will start with the first text view. For first text view, the background color is this. I will take this. I will copy it. How to apply background color? You have to use background property hash, paste that color, and as per the requirement, text color should be white. So let me change text color. That is 3Fs. So with this you can observe here, puzzles color is reflected. Second text view color, I will copy paste. I will use these two properties for other text views also. I will copy and I will paste, and then I will change the background color accordingly, and I will repeat this process for all other text views. With this I am almost done with the screen design, but we have to do some minor modifications. If you observe the screen design carefully, I will maximize this. If you observe, the text in all text views should be aligned at the center. On the left hand side of the content, I need 20 pixels of the space. Tell me, how will you give this space? First, let us move this content to the center. How to move the content to the center of your view? Will you use gravity property or layout gravity property? Obviously, for content movement, for content alignment, we should use gravity property. I will try to apply gravity property for first text view. If it is working properly, then I will copy paste same property for remaining text views. You can apply that property anywhere within the angular brace. So when I am applying a gravity center, that content is actually moving to the center of text view. But what I want is, I want that content to be at the center only, but not exactly in the middle. Maybe at the starting position, that is here. So currently puzzles was here. I want to move vertically to the center. This is like horizontally center. This position is called as vertical center. So let us see if there is a vertical center property. I will use control space. You can observe center horizontal and center vertical. If you use center horizontal, it will move horizontally to the center position. If you use center vertical, currently it was here vertically. This is called as vertical position. Vertically it will move to center. If you use directly center, it is both vertical center plus horizontal center. So it will come here. That means I should use gravity center vertical for all other text views also. I will copy and I will paste. So with this, all elements are aligned correctly. Now only remaining thing is, we need to specify this extra space. How to do this? This is space within the box in terms of pixels. So we should use padding left 20 pixels. So now I will go to each text view. I will give padding left 20px, but using px is a bad design. Use dp. So with this, our screen design is almost done. I will paste same property for all other text views so that content will move accordingly. So this is something like hit and trial. If 20dp is not fitting for your requirement, you can change that value at any point of time. So with this, our screen design is over and our final screen design looks like this. So this is what expected initially. The only new point which we have learned in this session is how to apply image to an image view. First, put that image in the drawable folder, then use src property within the image view and specify @drawable/your image name. That's it. Now I will show you the real power of applying weights. No matter whether you are running your application in a small phone or in the bigger phone, this look and feel will not be disturbed. It will be having always uniform look and feel. Let me show you. Currently I am running application in Nexus 4. Currently we are seeing application in Nexus 4. Let me select Nexus S. Even in this also, the look is same only. That means no matter whether you are running your application on the small phone or bigger phone, our application is fitting exactly to the screen size, whether it is small screen or big screen. So that is an important point which you have to observe here. Now let me select Nexus 5. So still it is fitting exactly to the screen size. That is the power of weights. I hope you understood this concept.